요즘 궁금한 게 있으면 포털 사이트에 물어봅니다. 제일 좋은 건 본인에게 물어보는 것입니다.
네, 어쿠스틱 좀 아는 남자들의 기타 리뷰 어쿠스틱 타임즈 지금 시작하겠습니다. 오늘 굉장히 특별한 손님이 와 계십니다. 네, 일단 우리 스페셜 게스트 앤디 네. 모시고 시작하겠습니다. 일단 앤디와 시작하기 전에 명함 씨가 해주셨던 인트로의 의미에 대해서 한번 간단하게 듣고 넘어가 볼까요?
사실 저희가 테일러를 되게 많이 했잖아요. 네네네. 오래 하기도 했고 여러 기종을 하기도 했었고 궁금한 게 많이 생겼단 말이죠. 그거에 대한 궁금증을 풀 수 있는 저로의 기회가 아닐까.
그렇죠.
우리끼리 생각하고 우리끼리 의논한 것보단
그렇죠.
본인에게 물어보는 게
그렇죠.
더 좋지 않을까.
스스로 가장 그 답을 잘 해줄 수 있는 게스트를 그렇죠. 여기다 모셔놓고 진짜 말 그대로 테일러에 대한 궁금증을 완전히 해소할 수 있는 저로의 기회가 아닐까라는 생각이 듭니다. 그래서 제가 진짜 참 좋은 기회들이 많은 게 테일러에 대해서 궁금하면 테일러 사람한테 물어보면 된다.
그렇죠.
이런 기회를 우리가 어디서 얻을 수 있겠습니까?
맞아요.
네, 그래서 and please say hello to subscribers of this channel.
Hello everybody.
Yeah,
great to be here. I always enjoy coming to Korea. I've had some really good memories here, and I've met a lot of really good guitar players.
Yeah,
a lot of really really good guitar players in this country. So it's always a pleasure to come here.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. 네, 자 이렇게 늘 오는 게 즐겁다고 하시고 14년째 지금 오고 계시고요. 네, 오늘은 저희가 테일러 기타에 새롭게 런칭된 그 시리즈인 그랜드 퍼시픽 라인에 대해서 주로 좀 알아볼 거예요. 저희가 얼마 전에 그거를 여러분들께 새로운 라인이 나왔다고 이제 설명을 드렸었는데 그때 저희가 이제 말씀드렸던 게 그게 이제 라운드 숄더의 드레드넛 쉐입이라고 말씀을 드리면서 드디어 이 뒷자리가 이제 7, 717, 317, 뭐 517 이렇게 하고 저희가 3개를 리뷰를 그때 했었는데 이게 이제 뭐 정확하게 말하자면 이 그랜드 퍼시픽이라는 것 자체가 이제 뭐 시리즈 이름이기도 하고 그리고 이제 그 쉐입을 애초에 그 상징하는 말로 이제 앞으로 그 드레드넛이라는 말보다는 그냥 이제 그랜드 퍼시픽이라고 얘기를 하면은 라운드 숄더로 나온 드레드넛을 지칭하는 테일러의 새로운 라인이다.
그렇죠. 그냥
이렇게 생각을 하시면 될 것 같습니다. 그래서 오늘 저기서부터 7, 3, 7, 3, 5
맞아요.
이렇게 놓여져 있어요. 그래서 7, 1, 7 그리고 3, 1, 7, 5, 1, 7 이렇게 이따가 앤디가 직접 이 그랜드 퍼시픽에 대한 저희의 질문에 대해서 답해 주시면서 시연도 직접 해주실 거고 심지어 또 싱어송라이터시기 때문에 멋진
맞아요.
노래도 저희가 들어볼 기회가 있지 않을까 생각이 듭니다. 자 이렇게 간단하게 오늘 저희가 뭘 할지에 대해서 개괄을 한번 해봤고요. 그럼 바로 처음 질문 들어가 볼게요. 처음 질문은 테일러와 다른 기타의 저희가 차이에 대해서 과연 이 아시아 총괄 담당 14년차 앤디는 어떻게 생각하시는지 물어보도록 하겠습니다. Here is the first question.
Okay.
And what do you think is the biggest difference between the Taylor guitars and other brands?
Oh, that's a good question. I come from a retail background. Okay. I used to have a guitar store in Chicago. Acoustic guitar store. And that was a customer, that was a common question for lots of customers. What's the difference? I think that to sum it up quickly, I think that Taylor has always been a company that's it's all about moving forward. Bob Taylor has a saying where he says we're gonna make our best guitar tomorrow.
That's a good thing.
And then tomorrow he says we're gonna make our best guitar tomorrow. Moving forward, and he as a builder and as a developer of a company, he's always embraced change. He's embraced technology to try to evolve the guitar. We're not trying to make recreations of guitars that were great 50 years ago.
Yeah,
we've never done that. And Grand Pacific is kind of the next step. It's a new shape for us. Yeah. And so that's an example of a company that's always trying to change and try to get improve every day.
Oh, okay. That's the biggest difference between...
Well, that's a philosophical difference,
yeah,
right?
I know.
So as far as specs and things like that, I think that I've heard Bob Taylor speak before, and one of the things that he's most proud of in his history is the development of the NT neck. The way that the neck joins the body on our guitar is completely different than any other manufacturer.
Okay.
And the result of it is that you can very easily adjust the neck angle in relation to the body. The neck is held on with 3 bolts.
Yeah.
There's no glue. And then there's a set of spacers that go in the pocket. So you can always adjust the neck angle on the guitar very quickly. And there's several really qualified repair techs in Korea right now who know how to do that work and can do it fast. And so it doesn't require any major surgery. No big job. So that always it always assures the buyer and the player that your guitar will always play well. It's not, you know, in 10 years it's not the neck's not going to cave in because all you have to do is take it off and change the spacers to readjust it. So the anti-neck is a big part of what Bob is super proud of. And that's a big change. We've always been a company that's tried to do our own thing. The expression system, both expression system 1 and now 2, are developed in-house, engineered in-house, manufactured in-house in the factory. And so I think that that's part of the story. I'm going to say one more thing. I know this is a really long answer. Yeah. Sorry. but one more thing that has happened now is that Bob Taylor has hired his successor, Andy Powers. Andy is the main designer. He's in charge of all the design. Grand Pacific is his body shape. And what Bob is doing now is spending the rest of his life working on forestry issues.
Oh, really?
He's planting trees.
That's good.
Yeah. It's something that nobody else is doing.
Now, this is very important.
And this is something that he feels is very important because he's made a living off the forests, right?
Okay.
Yeah. So far, but no one in the history of guitar building, very few people in any industry, have gone back to plant trees for the next generation. So as you guys know, we're getting to the point now where we woods that we used to take for granted are hard to get now.
It's not easy
to get good mahogany. Easy to get rosewood. And it's being protected by environmental issues. So what Bob is doing now is going back, and he's actually planting ebony trees in Cameroon, Africa, and he's growing that ebony business to be a sustainable business that does, we say above ground, which means no bribery, which is very tough to do in a country like Africa, to have a business without bribery. And he's also just purchased land in Hawaii, where he's growing a koa forest.
Oh, really? Koa forest, yeah. It's not like gardening, and it's like industry or thing. Mm.
So he's doing things that are, he's planting koa trees so that maybe your grandchildren will have koa or good ebony or whatever wood he plants on this DPG. Land.
As a human, he'll
never see it in his lifetime.
Yeah.
But he's thinking about that. So that's part of the culture of our company I'm really proud of.
Was really great answer that philosophically and technically, and we've done everything we need this review. So it's all okay,
cool.
Yeah, okay, that's good.
You're done?
Okay.
Yeah, everything is done.
Let's get a beer.
It was really great. Okay, next question, and it's about a V-Class. And what made you develop the V-Class, and what is the main features or merits of it?
Well, this answer is really good from the last question you asked, because it's an example of change. And making something different, and making something that's unique. And Andy Powers joined our company around 8 years ago, and what he did for the first part of his career is pretty much take all of Bob's designs and make them better. He did things like he changed the size of the bracing, and he changed the glue that was used, and he changed the wood thickness that was used, and he changed lots of little things that made the guitar just a little bit better. So in 2014, he revoiced the whole 800 series, which is one of our most popular. The 814 CE is one of the most popular acoustic guitars in the world.
I love it.
And so that's a really good example, because even when I had my store, I had my guitar store from 1993 to 2005, and the 814s that I sold then, there's been like 7 different models of that guitar since then. And they're all
7 different guitars.
They're all great.
Yeah, I know.
Right, but every time we're trying to make them better, and the V Class is Andy's. He kind of reached a point where he thought there's nothing else that, as a designer, he could do with an X-Brace. He didn't. He was out of ideas. So he started to experiment with this new idea called V-Class.
I think it's really good.
Yes.
Yeah. It's not. I think it's not like something is better than something. It's not like that thing. Yeah.
I don't think so either.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
You know, I'm lucky because I've been playing guitar for a long time and I have a nice collection of guitars. You know, I have, I don't know, 30 guitars or something like that.
No.
15 electrics, 15 acoustics. V-Class is not going to make me get rid of all my X-Brace guitars.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's the point. Yes. Yeah.
But I don't have any X-Brace guitars that do what these guitars do.
Yeah, that's right.
So so that's how I think about it. I think about it as a musician. It's another tool to use. And when I say that I don't have anything that does what this design does, what I mean is that I don't have anything that's as accurate.
Yeah.
These are super accurate guitars. Yeah.
Accurate.
And I'll show you what I mean in a second by that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Before you play the guitars.
Yeah.
I want to know what you think is the biggest differences between the X racing and V racing.
Okay.
And explaining this, you can just demonstrate guitars for it.
Sure. Okay. I think that the biggest difference that I hear as a guitar player is an increased amount of sustain.
Sustain.
Oh.
A much more in tune guitar. The intonation. The in-tuneness of chord from chord to chord is much improved.
Yes.
And then I also hear what in English we call it bloom.
Bloom.
Like when you sit at a piano and you play a big chord on a grand piano and you put the sustain pedal down.
Yeah.
Bloom.
The sound blooms.
Ah, it's like
it evolves. It changes.
Okay, yeah.
Right.
Ah.
Different harmonics come in.
Yeah.
Right. Different frequencies kind of roll in and out.
Paisan 같은 느낌인가?
It's like spreading.
It's growing and changing in a pleasant way. And I think that because the V-Class concept allows the top of the guitar to vibrate in a completely different way than X-Brace.
Yeah.
So you hear this bloom, this change, this evolution of sound more than in an X-Brace design.
Yeah.
So I'll show you what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna just play something really simple into the microphone here. V-Class, first of all, the brace comes right down the middle. And instead of having four different quadrants of soundboard that are trying to produce sound, you basically have two.
In X-Bracing?
In V-Class. Because the main brace is coming through here, right?
Oh, yeah.
So you've got one side and one side.
Mm. Yes.
Instead of division by four.
Yeah, four on that. It's two.
So it allows the top to move completely differently.
Oh.
And so you can play. Just listen to how long a sustain. I'll play just one simple note. And this is not necessarily a real resonant note on guitar, but just listen to how long this note lasts for.
That's very long.
Still going.
Yeah. Yeah.
You hear the harmonics coming in over time?
It's like bloom.
Yeah, that's the word, right?
Bloom. Yeah.
And certain chords really. Okay, so that's a great example. This overtone, that note, I'm not playing that note.
Yeah.
But you hear it about 3 seconds after the chord starts to bloom. Check it out.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
It's really fun just like to sit around it and to play chords like that and listen to the change. Mm. The other main thing that I think that I talked about, intonation.
Yeah.
In-tuneness. All guitar players learn this at some point. And I know you know it because you're a great guitar player. But but when you first start out playing guitar, you get your tuner out, you put it on the headstock.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Right? You tune it up.
Yes. Yeah.
And then the E chord might sound really nice, but the A chord?
Yes.
The C sharp?
Yes.
The third?
Yes.
Is going to be too sharp?
Yes.
Right?
Yes, right.
So you have to retune it, right? So,
yes.
But check this out on this guitar.
That sounds pretty in tune to me. All right, here's your A chord.
Mm. 그런 경우가 있지. Mm.
So that's what I mean. I don't have any guitar. I have a lot of nice guitars.
Yeah.
I don't have anything that does that.
Okay.
That well.
Yeah.
So now you've got this, you have the ability to, one of the voice, the first time I ever learned that lesson, this voicing here, like the kind of a triad shape, right? A D chord. And this, but this at the 10th fret or the 9th fret is never in tune.
Ah, yeah, that's true.
Right?
That's right. Yeah, that's right.
The fifth
yeah.
is always flat.
Yeah. All
right. 튠 밸런스가 좋다는 얘기잖아요, 네. 그죠?
So,
this sounds so nice. It's pretty good.
No problem. Yeah. So now listen to how in tune this guitar is, and how long it sustains for.
Yeah. Yeah, but I think the pitch is not about the bracing thing.
It is.
Yeah.
Oh. No, it is.
Really?
Yeah.
그것 때문에 지금 그렇다는 얘기인 거잖아.
The pitch is.
How does it work?
It well, so if you ask Andy about this, he'll say that because of the way that the top vibrates, there's less competition from the soundboard itself in different areas.
Ah.
So when you play a note. It's like a trans. The soundboard is kind of a translator from the strings into the body, and it's so the way that it works is more of like a rocking motion. It's much more. There's less competition from. He says the word chaos. Chaos is a little intense for translation purposes, but less places. It's just more efficient. It allows it to vibrate in a different way.
Yeah,
and so again. Really in tune.
맞네. 힘들지.
It kind of allows you to play chords that you wouldn't do in play in the past, and like using open strings with fretted notes, like mandolin voicings, mandolin chord voicings. Intonation, sustain, bloom, accuracy.
Okay.
I think that to my ear, that's what this design does. That's what V-Class does.
And it's shocking that how it vibrates, it affects the pitch and tune.
It's cool in here because it's so quiet that you can really hear what I'm talking about.
Yeah. It's very amazing experience. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So we are, as a company, transitioning all our USA-made guitars to V-Class.
Yeah, all USA guitars,
all the USA Grand Auditoriums, Grand Symphonies, Grand Orchestra, Grand Pacific, and Grand Concert, which is a small body.
Yeah.
They're all going to be V-Class by the end of next year.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. Okay, the next question. And after this question, you're going to demonstrate on... by alligator. 703, okay.
Yes, it's lovely. She walks in free. Swinging side each stride, every sighting a sight to see. Flower girl, flower girl. If motion ocean with money, she'd be a millionaire. Extraordinary, evil's rule affair. The turn of her shoulders, the trail of hair, the flower girl. Flower girl.